Good morning. This is Swift Passage. Thanks for tuning in. Thanks for all you new subscribers. This is God's holy channel. I want to give you an encouraging dream I had last night, and I want to talk to you about a little bit about saved by grace through faith. So I'm going to give you this dream. I woke up at 2:30 in the morning. I couldn't go back to sleep. I said, look, I prayed for all you guys on this that are sub to me, all you guys with problems, everything. You know the Lord's watching, and he's hearing your prayers. We've been sending your prayers up to the kingdom of God, and he's been hearing your prayers. I went to sleep about 4 a.m. I had a dream. I believe it was an angel. I was led to believe this was an angel. He came into my room. He came up to me. He put his arms on me, and I was laying down in the bed. And I shook violently, and I heard claps. I heard thunder and lightning, claps of thunder. I mean, all this at once. And I shook. It was pretty intense. And at the same time, I heard like I was in a bowling alley, and I heard the bowling ball strike the pins. It was very clear and detailed. I heard the bowling alley ball, the bowling ball, strike and hit the pins. So I felt I was in a bowling alley. Then he released me. He walked away. I saw him walk away, and he was at the door, and I said, wait. And I got up, and I gave him a hug, and I said, thank you. And he didn't say anything. He smiled and turned and walked out the door. I wanted to share that with you. I believe it's it's a strike that's going to take place. The claps of thunder and lightning is going to cause the rapture of the church. That's what I got in my spirit from that. I thank the Lord for, I asked him one more time, give me one more confirmation, Lord, that's very close. And that's what he gave me. So I want to talk a little bit about the sealing of the Holy Spirit. When you said the sinner's prayer and you repented of all your sins and you gave your life to Christ, you meant with all your heart and soul, you became sealed by God. In Ephesians 1, verse 13 and 14, you are sealed by God until redemption day. So if you fall back into sin, you're still sealed by God. You don't ever lose your salvation. That's what's so awesome about giving your life to Christ. But you must ask for forgiveness and work to not do it again. I'll take that back. Work. I don't like using that word. Try not to do that again. Saved by grace through faith, it's not by works. It's by the grace of God. Jesus died on the cross for our sins. He bled his precious blood on the cross. He died on the cross for you and me so we could have eternal life with him in the kingdom of God. As long as we said this sinner's prayer and gave our life to Christ and tried to live right by God and follow Jesus Christ. You know, just because someone said the sinner's prayer and they meant with all their heart and soul, they became sealed by God, doesn't mean they're going to follow Christ. They could live in the world, live a worldly life, and be still sealed by God, saved by God. because you never lose your salvation. You are sealed until the day of redemption. Go with me over to Ephesians 1, verse 13 and 14. In whom ye also trusted, after that ye heard the word of truth, the gospel of your salvation, in whom also after that ye believed, ye were sealed with that Holy Spirit of promise. Ye were sealed with that Holy Spirit of promise, which is the earnest of our inheritance until the redemption of the purchased possession, unto the praise of his glory. Unto the praise of his glory. You could go back in one of my previous videos back, the sealing of the Holy Spirit. I believe the heading is the seal, the Holy Spirit of promise. You can go back and look at that video where I explain it more in detail there. Go with me over to Ephesians 2, chapter 2, verse 8 and 9. For by grace are ye saved through faith. You said the sinner's prayer and became born again. You are saved through faith. And that not of yourselves. It's not of yourselves. It is a gift of God. The gift of God. Not of works. You don't work for your salvation. It is a gift from God. Not of works, lest any man should boast. Not of works, lest any man should boast. Listen, guys, if you're watching chat, you're looking at channels that are saying you can lose your salvation. You don't. You don't. God's not a liar. He's not going to go back on his word. God will not go back on his word. These people are making God out to be a liar. God is not a liar. When you're truly born again, saved by grace, you are sealed until the day of redemption. Until the day of redemption. You know, I'm not going to go back into this. If you guys want to discuss this, I'm not going to mention this again, because there's I have the previous video on the sealing of the Holy Spirit. On the sealing of the Holy Spirit. The words are in front of you. God doesn't say something and take it back. That's what I love about God. God is love. He loves all his children. Even the sinners. He loves the sinners, but he doesn't love the sin. He loves the sinners, but he doesn't love the sin. Many people will come to Christ in the tribulation. Many people will come to Christ in the tribulation. I hope there's still a little time left. I hope that many will still come before then, which I believe they will. I hope that there's someone watching this channel that's not saved and wants to be saved today. Wants to be saved. I'm going to post a salvation prayer in the comment section down below. If you're wanting to be saved by grace through faith in Jesus Christ today, you're watching this channel for the first time. This channel is a love of the Father. This is not a condemning channel. The Pharisees condemn. This is not. I follow in the footsteps of Jesus Christ in love. You know, we're short on days. We're short on time. The Lord Jesus Christ is getting ready to come for the believers. Believers filled with the Holy Spirit. Many, I believe, are watching this channel that are already filled with the Holy Spirit. So, You guys know you're sealed and saved until Redemption Day. But there might be people watching this channel that are not. And I'm asking you today, come to the Lord today and be saved. Give your life to Christ. The time of chaos and destruction is at the door. Do I know how many days or weeks or months that we have left? No, I don't. But I believe this is a final year before judgment begins. So I'm asking you to come to Jesus Christ today and be born again, saved by grace through faith. If you want to email me privately and discuss that, my email is dvargus, V-A-R-G-U-S 25, at gmail.com. dvargus, V-A-R-G-U-S 25, at gmail.com. Come to Jesus today while there still is time before the seven-year tribulation begins. Because once the seven-year tribulation begins, you will have to die for your faith in Jesus Christ. You will have to die for your faith in Jesus Christ. Once again, thanks for all you guys, all your beautiful comments. If I haven't gotten back to all of you guys, it's because I've been swamped. I'm either on the phone quite a bit, or the emails are just, I'm overwhelmed with personal emails, or the comments in the comment sections. I try when I have a chance, especially late at night when I'm awake, to try to respond to comments. Know this, I read all your comments and I appreciate all your comments. If I haven't gotten back to you, forgive me. I have read your comment. Thanks for all your encouraging messages. Thanks for all your personal emails that have encouraged me greatly. I'm so grateful. This is the best time in my life, coming on here and working with all these brothers and sisters in Christ, getting prepared for the coming of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. This channel is a love of the Father. I have nothing to do with this. I pray every time before I upload a new video that the Lord leads for His glory, that I have nothing to do with this. It's all for the glory of God. You guys, stay encouraged. Stay encouraged. Ever close, God abide in me. Ever close, God abide in me. Shalom.
Eternal home, but for now I walk this broken world. You walked it first, you know our pain, but you sure hope can rise again up from the grave. Abide with me, abide with me. Don't let me fall, and don't let go. Walk with me, and never leave. Ever close, God, abide with me. There in the night, Gethsemane, before the cross, before the nails, overwhelmed, alone you prayed. You met our sin, our suffering, and bore our shame. Abide with me, abide with me. Don't let me fall. Don't let go. Walk with me and never leave. Ever. eternity. We'll weep no more and sing for joy. Abide with me. We'll weep no more and sing for joy. Abide.